I'm Warrant Officer First Class Menard.
I'm Warrant Officer Second Class Bolt.
And this is How to Be Edgy. This is quality YouTube.
Starch is an optional step you can use to make your pants look better. You have to be very careful when you use it and only spray it on the inside of your pants. Lay your pants on the ground, shake your can of starch, and spray it down along all of the creases on your pants. When done, fold the pants in half and do the other side.
It's important to remember to not use too much starch. Err on the side of caution. So use less starch than more, and it's always more. You also can't iron your pants right after starching. Your pants will still be wet when you go to Cadet. So you need to do this the day before that you iron. So here we're starching my pants, and then we're going to be ironing one off the Bolt's pants, which we starched yesterday.
Prepare your iron safely using common sense. Here I'm holding up my pants where you can see the end goal of where you want your creases to be, centered up and down along the entire leg of your pants, up to the belt loops on the front and angled to that center back loop.
Yeah, so in the back you can see that they meet together actually. They're not next to it, they meet together at the back there.
Here you can see I have two creases, those are called railroad tracks. At the end of the video we will show you how to fix those. But on the back, my creases are kind of straight, but they're supposed to angle in towards that belt loop.
So to help with this, we're going to lay our pants out flat on the iron here. And then we're just lying on flat, getting rid of all the wrinkles. And then we're going to reach into the pants here. We're going to pull out the inside pocket so it is not underneath where we will be ironing. Okay. Then we're going to fold up our pants here, the top leg of our pants, and we're going to keep pulling out that pocket to make sure we are not ironing it at all. It's hard to see here, but you will be able to feel it by pulling it out. Don't touch your iron.
It is hot. Be safe.
And test it to make sure that it's already heated up.
Be safe.
Yeah. Next step is ironing. So you're going to put your finger down to pinch the crease there, and you're going to place your pressing cloth. Your pressing cloth is so important. If you do not iron your iron with a pressing cloth, you will burn your pants, leaving shiny marks, burn marks, bad creases, bad railroad tracks. It is very important that you use a pressing cloth.
Also, if you're using any form of starch and stuff on your hairspray, using a pressing cloth helps prevent that from getting it on the iron if you spray too much. Once again, make sure when you place the iron down, face it away from you on the ironing board.
Yeah. Pressing cloth can be a t-shirt or like a pillowcase. One Officer Bolt uses a tea towel.
It's a tea towel my grandma made.
Yeah. Okay, so you can see, once again, we're pinching the crease. Well, Warrant Officer Bolt's pinching the crease. And then we're smoothing it out along the length, okay? If there are any wrinkles in your pressing cloth and you iron them, you will be ironing them into your pants, which is not the end goal.
You can't really tell in the video, but I'm using all the muscles in my arm and my superhuman strength to use lots of pressure while ironing the creases. If you iron lightly, you're kind of defeating the purpose because you want to make sure you have nice sharp creases.
Yeah, do not iron on top of any
patterns,
decals. One Officer Bolt irons a nice pretty pattern into her pants once in band camp.
Yep, they were cats. Don't do that. Once again, I'm pinching my crease at the top and making sure I'm using lots of steam to make sure the crease is in the right place.
And lots of steam, lots of repetition, lots of pressure, just like ironing your shirt, but all with a pressing cloth and some starch this time. Once again, pinching, placing the pressing cloth, pinching again, smoothing it out.
Last week I made a railroad track, so I accidentally ironed my crease in the wrong spot, so I don't fix it quite yet here, but I'm being very careful while ironing the top of my pants there.
Yeah, and you see how she moves her pressing cloth along her pants, so she's always there's always pressing cloth covering where she is ironing.
The supply officers will be very mad at you if you make your pants shiny. They will make fun of you. You do not want to be made fun of.
No. Pinch. Pull out pocket. Pinch again.
Smooth.
Pressing cloth. Pinch.
I always keep a finger down. Pinching.
Do not iron on your finger.
That will hurt.
And you will be sad.
Next, we will be looking at the hem of the pants. If you take your pants to a seamstress or to your mom or whoever to get them hemmed, make sure that the hem is 2 inches thick. As well, your pant hem needs to be down to the first eyelet of the bottom of your boot. Here we found some wrinkles, so we're removing our pressing cloth and ironing on the top edge of the pants.
Ta-da! Checking out creases, looking for mistakes. Plugging our iron, and now we're going to do some correction with a hair straightener. This step is optional, but it really, really can help to enhance your pants, get those last little details.
So that railroad track I had earlier, this makes it super easy to fix them, and it helps you be super precise and fix any of your errors.
Yeah, however, a word of caution, it is very easy to burn your pants with a straightener. This one's pretty little and doesn't get too hot, but if you are not careful and you iron, flat iron too quickly, you could burn your pants once again.
Mine is a travel straightener, so it doesn't get too hot, so just be careful.
Go over your creases with these. These are great if you're a staff cadet and you need to quickly fix your creases.
I was unhappy there with the way the crease was centered on that belt loop, so I'm going over it with my iron to make sure that the crease goes to the center of the belt loop. Be very diligent with your creases.
It's worth it.
Ironing down. Here's a trick you can use with a hanger if you don't have a pants hanger. Put the belt loops on the little edges there.
And then you can just use a pants hanger. Always hang up your pants or you've wasted all of your work. I'm Warrant Officer First Class Menard.
I'm Warrant Officer Second Class Bolt.
And I'm Perry the Cat.
Thank you for watching.
Yay!